What up, guys? It's Jules here from What Culture Gaming, and today I've got something a bit special for you because once again, we're going to go off the beaten track of the AAA gaming scene and look at some indie moments. Hit that title. So today, we're going to be talking about Dark Souls. Now, I know what you're thinking. Dark Souls is a big game. I hear you cry, Jules, it's not an indie title, and I totally agree with you. But what I'm trying to do is give you 5 recommendations for indie games that carry the same tone. So even if you've still got your fire left to kindle once you've finished the game, there's going to be something there to support that darkness. So let's get cracking.
Number 5, Shrouded in Sanity. Gothic vibe, check. Familiar inventory system, check. Relentless combat, check. Oh, Satan, you best believe it's a check. Shrouded in Sanity wears its Dark Souls influence proudly, but also draws inspiration from horror survival titles like Resident Evil, as the game sees you explore a massive mansion brimming with mad servants and unholy ghouls. The combat of the game focuses around positioning rather than countering, as if you stand toe to horrific toe with these enemies, you're likely to lose. However, if you utilize space and timing to your advantage, it becomes a system reminiscent of jousting. It's for this reason that Shrouded in Sanity is at the top of this list, as I know that not all fans of the Souls will get behind it, but in terms of tone and presentation, it is a great place to start. Number 4, Dark Mouse. With its dour presentation, familiar heads-up display, and obsession with bonfires, you'd be forgiven for thinking that Dark Mouse as just a top-down Dark Souls, but there is so much more than that in this mousy mission of masochism. The top-down approach allows developer Daniel Wright the ability to use line of sight as a key mechanic. So, as you enter rooms, you might suddenly be ambushed or get a glimpse of an upcoming battle so you can get better prepared. It's an excellent way to keep the player constantly on their toes and an easy way to make them fall into traps. F*** you. Death is an important feature of the Souls experience, and Dark Mouse deals with death in a really interesting way. In many areas, you can do nothing other than meet your maker, as enemies are purposefully much stronger than your rowdy rodent. The twist is, however, that upon your death, you respawn alongside ghostly mice called Shades. These Shades travel along the same path you did in your previous life and disappear if you move beyond that point. They also fight anything you encounter along the way, meaning that in Dark Mouse, you're actually more likely to succeed the more you fail. Number 3, Death's Gambit. When speaking about the creation of Death's Gambit, the developers at Adult Swim stated that their animation system was key to making the game not only look amazing, but also keeping it fair. Across the Souls series, there have always been some iffy hitboxes and ways to exploit them, but that's not the case here. As if you can learn the visual prompts, then you'll always escape the clutches of death, well, for at least another 10 seconds or so. It's a Castlevania Souls affair with multi-tiered 2D levels and a much greater focus on environmental interaction. In a recent demo of the game, players take on a demon whilst trying to balance on an icy platform. If the weight shifts too far in either direction, then that spells the end of the run, therefore you're left in a precarious situation of dodging, attacking, and watching out that you don't slip off the edge like a bloodstained version of Crash Bash. Now, truth be told, that Death's Gambit isn't out at the moment, but it's looking like a must-have for any Souls fans. Number 2, Salt and Sanctuary. Horror has always been a core element of the Souls games, with towering monsters grotesque in appearance making up the backbone of your encounters. Salt and Sanctuary reflects this tone in an almost comic book form. There's a lot of similar beats in SAS which will instantly make Souls fans feel at home. Sanctuaries act as bonfires, salt replaces souls, enemies respawn upon resting, and notes in a bottle act as player messaging. Now, at this juncture, I should probably tell you about the features that make it differ, but what Salt and Sanctuary does so well is take these features and make them work on a 2D plane. The combat is satisfying throughout, and let's face it, because you're going to be replaying areas again and again, it had to be. And number 1, Hyper Light Drifter. Just because Hyper Light Drifter's color palette is a lot more vibrant than Dark Souls, its themes are surprisingly similar, with a focus on loss, devastation, and the long journey to rebirth. The combat is a lot quicker as well, but enemies hit just as hard, meaning that encounters can become intense rushes of chain dashing, lightning fast swipes, and returning enemy projectiles with well-timed button presses. The story is also reminiscent of Dark Souls in that there's a great deal of player interpretation with the lore that's presented. It's all told through fragmented images, and it takes a lot of work to piece together, but it's rewarding nonetheless. It's beautiful, it's bleak, and it's well worth a try.
And those are 5 indie games that are like Dark Souls. Let me know what you thought and if you've got any more recommendations down in the comment below. And wait, we're going to be doing some polls because I want to know what you'd like to see me cover next, see me burrow through into the dark corners of the indie universe. So do yourself a favor and use this little thing up here to let me know what you want to see next. If not, just have a crack down at me in the comment about how I've got an upside down head. It's usually good for a laugh. As always, I've been Jules, you've been awesome, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye-bye. Hey guys, thanks for watching the video. Don't forget to subscribe below, and if you're looking for more content like this, then try a few things that are floating about around my ears. Might be fun. I can't promise it though, but it might be.